Welcome to ESPN Plus Hockey Nights, presented by New Amsterdam Vodka. Moments away from Jack Eichel's return to Buffalo. And what is on the mind of 25-year-old Jack Eichel? What are his nerves like as he makes his final preparations this morning and this afternoon to take the ice in front of fans who only once cheered him and now tonight will certainly boo him? The scar from his neck surgery just above his tie knot, a reminder of what the last year has been like in the life of Jack Eichel.
They say the only constant in life is change. And while it may be inevitable, it can still come as a surprise. For when something begins,
Buffalo selects Jack Eichel.
We rarely think about it ending.
It's a moment I've dreamed of my entire life.
Welcome to the future! One-timer scores! The Eichel Tower is back!
But then, without notice, it happens.
They're messy. They have no confidence.
I'm fed up with the losing. I'm frustrated.
Jack Eichel will get the disc replacement surgery that he wants.
Jack Eichel is no longer the captain of the Buffalo Sabres.
The long soap opera is over. He was traded to the Vegas Golden Knights.
It obviously ended a little bit messy.
Change always tells two stories. The end of one chapter.
Yeah, we showed him.
Our chances of winning without him, they're zero.
Beginning of a new.
This was the place I wanted to be more than anywhere.
Centered, Eichel scores! Eichel on a breakaway, they score!
Change forces us to move on, but it never forces us to forget where we began.
What a difference a year makes. Fans making their way in the KeyBank Center here in downtown Buffalo. Some with Vegas jerseys, some still with Buffalo jerseys. He will have some support tonight as he laces them up for the Vegas Golden Knights, a team that's just struggling since the All-Star break. The playoffs are on the line. They need Jack Eichel to get going and quickly as he tries to ease his way back into being a professional player. Some boos, some support. Emily Kaplan is ringside with Jack Eichel.
Jack, this is your first time back in Buffalo in a Golden Knights sweater. What emotions are you experiencing right now?
I'm just trying to get ready to play a game. It's a big game for our team. We need 2 points here. We know they're going to be desperate. Just a big night for us.
Thanks, Jack.
Thanks, Emily.
I think Jack was ready for another question, but I ran into him today when we left the morning skate. He said it's not so much about fitness. It's about really getting his timing back to rip those wrist shots, his spatial awareness. How much time does he have when he goes into the corner with the puck? That's the stuff that's coming back slower. He feels strong. He started powerlifting again. He wasn't able to do that because of the neck all summer long. And if you forget about the timeline, well, here it is. He was drafted to be the savior here. Connor McDavid went one. Jack Eichel went number two. He was their best player right away, led the team in goals, assists, and points during his time here. Then he suffers the herniated disc. There was a disagreement on what kind of surgery to get. That leads to a trade, even though he already asked for the trade before the injury. He gets the disc replacement surgery after Vegas acquires him, makes his debut in mid-February. And here we are now, on the ice, preparing for this return. One other thing to get out of the way to return to being a normal professional hockey player. All kinds of fans and signs along the perimeter of the Vegas end. So glad to be here tonight calling the game with Ray Ferraro. And Ray, what does Vegas get in Jack Eichel?
Well, they've gotten a player that they've never had before. I mean, they've had terrific success in their young history. You see the trade that they were able to make. It was a difficult trade for Kevin Adams and the Buffalo Sabres to make, yet they get Alex Tuch and Peyton Krebs, a first, likely this year, and a second rounder. Now, they've had great success in Vegas. However, they've never had somebody in the middle that's a difference maker. Jack Eichel's one of the top 10 centers in the National Hockey League when he's healthy. This is his game winner on Sunday against Ottawa in overtime. They go to Philly, lead 2-1. He has nine shots and an assist. Pete DeBoer said, much as you just mentioned, he's getting more comfortable. He's got the 3 goals in 10 games. They haven't really figured out or flushed out who his line mates are going to be. Tonight, Jonathan Marchessault will move to his right wing and Max Pacioretty on his left. I think if they ever get everybody healthy, it'll be Mark Stone. But what a player that Vegas has in their lineup.
Tough trade to make. Kevin Adams didn't rush it. He wanted to get a good return for this special player. Eichel trades agent, gets Bresson to kind of help push this along. They make the trade. And boy, in terms of talent, it looks like they got a good return. But to get a guy from the Buffalo area like Alex Tuch, that's gold.
Well, the draft picks were always going to be something a part of this.
Right.
Now, here's Alex Tuch as a youngster cheering his Buffalo Sabres, and now he gets to come and play here. He was enthusiastic from the day he set foot in Buffalo. He changed, as Kevin Adams and Coach Don Granato mentioned this morning to us, he changed the air around the Sabres, the way they looked at themselves, the demand of success. He's coming from a successful program. It's one thing to say you're rebuilding. You need somebody to lead the way that can actually produce. He's doing that. He's almost a point-of-game player.
Possible future captain. He's in lineup. Peyton Krebs also in the lineup tonight. With more on Jack Eichel, here is Emily Kaplan again between the benches.
Guys, I flew to Vegas last week to spend some time with Jack Eichel, and we discussed what he was expecting in his return to Buffalo, as well as his perspective of how things ended with the Sabres. I got more than one question in. Give it a listen.
All right, breaking news here on SportsCenter AM from the NHL, where Jack Eichel is headed to Vegas. Eichel and the Sabres had been at odds on how to handle his needed neck surgery.
What was going through your mind when you found out you were going to be on the Vegas Golden Knights?
This was the place I wanted to be more than anywhere. So I was definitely pretty excited. You know, getting a call from Kelly and getting a call from George and Mr. Foley, like, you know, just so welcoming and so supportive of sort of what I wanted to do, and I couldn't have been happier.
Out in front, all alone with Stevenson, couldn't pull the trigger, feeds it to Eichel, and he scores! Jack Eichel with his first as a member of the Golden Knights!
How did you feel when you scored your first goal for the Vegas Golden Knights?
Just relieved. It had been a while since I scored, and it's one of the things that you know, I want to try and bring to our group is production offensively. So whenever you're able to chip in, it's always good.
Jack Eichel! Oh my! What a play! The Eichel Tower on the rush.
How much pressure do you feel to perform here in Vegas like you did in Buffalo?
You know, it's funny. I think about this sometimes by myself, and I think you put pressure on yourself to perform because that's what you want to do. I think at times, maybe in Buffalo, I put too much pressure on myself, and I think it took a toll on me mentally, kind of, you know, leaving games, going home at night. It was tough at times. You know, you put a lot of pressure on yourself, and it feels like maybe if things don't go well, it's all on you. You know, since coming here, I've tried to kind of give myself a little more of a break. You know, sometimes it's just not going to go your way, and But I think pressure is a good thing. It's a privilege. It means you have high expectations. And I think the bar that's set for this organization is to win the Stanley Cup every year. And when that's your expectation every season, and that's a really good thing. So, you know, that's our expectation is to be there at the end.
What a long, strange trip it has been. You're looking live at Jack Eichel. There's juice in the building tonight, and you really haven't been able to say that for a lot of Sabre home games. More fans than usual as they're here for Jack Eichel's return. There was some support along the glass from signs. We saw the signs. It'll be very interesting to see and hear how many boos there are as Eichel makes the return. We are moments away from puck drop. Back to Steve Levy and the gang in the ESPN Plus studios. Vegas, Buffalo, exclusively on ESPN Plus is next.